initial term of 4 years, with the option to extend for a further 6 years, with that being renewed on a two-yearly basis. The previous contract was let and expires at the end of this month. We undertook a procurement exercise. We had three responses. One was from Cushman & Wakefield, DTZ. Those two firms have merged very recently, so there's a submission from them. There's one from BNP and one from CBRE. All were very credible, but CBRE were the most economically advantageous tender. In view of the time scales, we have appointed them under delegation, but the report is brought to this committee for members' information. Thank you, Chair.
Nick.
Thank you, Chair. I just wanted to ask whether or not the letting of this contract represents a change of contractor, or have you reappointed the previous contractor?
Yes, we have reappointed the incumbent.
So, happy to go with the recommendation.
This means the word of the delegation.
Yeah, delegation, yeah. Okay. Yeah. Okay, the next agenda item 9 is Treasury Management Policy. Again, Dolly, you can talk that through. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is to request Pensions Committee approve the Treasury Management Policy and the Treasury Management Practices for Merseyside Pension Fund for the year 2016-17. The policy statement is attached as an appendix to this report. There are no changes to the policy followed for 2015-16. Section 2 of the report outlines the background and key issues. Cllr Code of Practice for Treasury Management and Public Services requires Pensions Committee to receive an annual report on the strategies to be pursued in the coming year. The last policy was approved at this committee in January 2015. Section 2.2 reminds committee that the fund's cash flows from dealing with members has moved negative, with payments to pensioners exceeding income from contributions, and whilst investment income is directly reinvested, the levels of liquid resources held need to be adequate and daily cash flows and regular reporting is essential. 2.4 summarises that MPF will comply with the 12 Treasury Management Practices detailed in sections 4 to 15 in the appendix, and further explained in schedules 1 to 10 also within the appendix. The fund were run with minimum cash balances. The main aims for managing liquid resources are the security of capital, the liquidity of investments, and matching inflows from lending to predicted outflows. The achievement of high returns is of secondary importance to MPF compared with the security and liquidity of the asset. Counterparties are reviewed on a regular basis using a range of information detailed within the report. Section 3 informs committee that the Treasury Management Policy is concerned mainly with the mitigation of risks. The recommendation is within section 13 of the report, and if the committee approves the Treasury Management Policy and Treasury Management Practices for MPF 2016-17, approval of this policy forms part of the governance arrangements for Merseyside Pension Fund.
Thank you. Members, any questions of Donna? In that case, we're happy to approve the recommendation as given in 13.
Green.
of the travel costs still under the moment night accommodation may be required for the night before. Recommendation is that the committee considers if it wishes to send a delegation, and if so, to determine the number of an allocation of places. Thank you, Chair.
I know Peter hasn't been to this particular event run by this organisation, but very, very good actually. And if you've not already put your name down and you wish to attend, you should do so, because you will need a security pass, because it's in the housing department, so that will need to be arranged. And you'll need an overnight accommodation because it starts early. But they're very, very good, these events, very educational. I've certainly learned a lot from them, so those members who wish to attend, if they've not done so already, should contact them. Any questions? Okay. All right. Agenda item 12, local government pension scheme, local investments.
Yes, thank you, Chair. There'll be a number of... There's a great deal of interest in local investments, so I thought it was appropriate to prepare a paper just setting out some of the background to local investments. As we say under section 2.1, although we've not had an explicit allocation to investments in the local area, there have been a number of commercially viable opportunities over the years, and we still have around £50 million invested in the Merseyside region. Under section 2.2, more recently, we've had the combined authority established, the proposals for devolution. In addition to that, economic growth is clearly picking up, and we are seeing demand for housing, retail, leisure facilities in the area. And we feel that there will be more opportunities coming forward in a more coordinated way with these combined authorities, with devolution. There'll be the opportunity, better opportunities for us to invest in the years ahead. We also think that pooling with other LGPS funds should provide further resource and expertise in due course. Under 2.3, we're not proposing to change our criteria for the assessment of potential investments, but we are looking to be more active in identifying them, but also having regard to the management of risk. It's important that we do maintain diversification to avoid undue concentration in any one sector or geographical area. As we see under section 2.4, we do believe there's scope for further investment in the area. It is recognised that investments of this type are more resource intensive. Members may recall that I brought a report to this committee back in November 2013. We commissioned some work from the Smith Institute with four other local authority funds, and they set out a number of considerations, mainly around the more resource intensive nature of local investments. I've also then reminded members of fiduciary responsibilities. Under C, I think it's important to remember that as long as the precise choice of an investment may be influenced by wider social, ethical, or environmental considerations, so long as that does not risk material financial detriment to the fund. That's something we referred to in the previous report. So the recommendation is that members note the report and approve the intention to undertake regional investments consistent with our existing investment criteria. And as I say, we feel that devolution in the city region are expected to enable certain investments to be made, identified, and coordinated. Certainly see it as
opportunities there that we might be missing if we don't already have a working relationship between the six, sorry, five of district authorities within the MPF and the MPF itself.
Yeah, if I can comment on that from that same challenge pitch, by the way. Obviously, I've been pushing this along for quite a while, and Joe and myself and Peter have been at meetings where obviously investment's been spoken about, particularly where Manchester and West Yorkshire have been. It's my suggestion that we pull together, and I'm not sure of the right forum, and Joe and the officers will know better than I, an opportunity to perhaps meet with representatives of each of the authorities to explain perhaps investment opportunities in our Merseyside area. And also perhaps we might invite, or it might be appropriate or not, Greater Manchester, West Yorkshire to attend. I don't know, it needs thinking through, it needs some thought, but I think certainly bringing a forum together where a presentation is made to representatives from each authority would be beneficial. You happy with that, Joe?
Yeah, Chair, just on the basis of the council, we have a meeting a week on Friday with our internal investment team doing two things. One, the group potential investments, but also preparing for the discussion that you should be referring to. And we've already alerted the TPs and chief executives to that potential coming forward in the not too distant future.
Okay, any questions on that?
Joe said, I think it might be helpful if there's the thought given to a presentation to the Liverpool City Region Combined Authority, as I know, you know, the portfolio holder for economic regeneration is our own leader, Phil Davies, but to the wider Combined Authority, I think there's a number of fronts on which this can be done at the officer level, at the political level also. I think that would be...
Yeah, again, my fear is, you know, we'll have this pooled asset in Manchester, West Yorkshire, and all of a sudden we're seeing stuff going up in Tameside. I mean, that's my fear in all of this. So we need to make sure that we're pushing forward ourselves. Okay, so Joe, you're on that. I've already put a phone call into Neptune, by the way, about something on both sides, so it's as chair of pension fund, so let's see if we can push that along as well. So happy to note that report. Okay, agenda item 13. The following items, there are some exempt appendices and likes, but we are required as part of agenda item 13 to note and approve the minutes of the investment marketing working party. So if we're happy to agree those minutes.